this movie. What was it like for you, or did you, were you aware of the fact that you were sort of throwing everything into this movie?
I told you, I didn't get this part by being contained. If you give me a bottle with $10, I'm going to eat the $10. But beyond that, what happened is I wanted the movie to be a love letter to love and a love letter to cinema. And not only great cinema, I didn't want the movie to be called modern about cinema, where we go to the floor and Citizen Kane is playing in the theater. I wanted to say how great cinema is. In my biography, cinema has saved my life many times, for real. And not as having great cinema, Sunday cinema. Sometimes a silly comedy, a melodrama, in my case, being like kind of Pedro Infante movie, you can save your life. And you can go, I'll go on. I'm still in the on. Why not? And you close the faucet and pick up the razor blade and say another time. because film has that beautiful power to lift us from the troubles and I want the movie to be, I love that, the way it's shot. It's shot like a musical. When people say what movie do you study, I study Miami, Powell and Pressburger, Douglas Sirk. I didn't study horror movies, I studied cinema that was taking color, movement, beauty. And I wanted to, at 52, we were about to begin the production, I had a moment alone. And I really asked myself, what are you going to do that you haven't done? And I went to the places where the movie could be the most dangerous to do, and I executed it like that. And the most dangerous thing is tonally. Every decision for the actors, the camera, the music, the style, was to work across the board for comedy, and the drama, thriller, musical. That's really hard. So all 25 years of my craft, quarter of a century as a filmmaker, led me to this one.